the south get wild. Old school's coming down in a different color. Whip. Picture perfect. You might want to take a flick. Call up Jazzy, tell him pop the bottles, because we got another hit. Want to go platinum, I'm who you should get. Ludicrous on the track, get back, trick switch on the lack, I'm flexing steel. Same price, different time, hot song jumped on, because Sierra got sex appeal. And I keep the meanest, cleanest, baddest, spinning on stainless wheels. Could care less about your genius, I bump your status, I keep the stainless steel. Trunk rattling, what's happening, huh? I don't even think I need the speed. Bass traveling, bass crackling, huh? Turn it up and make the speakers bleed. Dirty South, we ballin', dog. And never think about falling, dog. Ghetto harmonizing, surprising, running back because the song is called.
What's going on, guys? I am back with another follow-up review this time of my DB15 7-inch AR. I did a video on it last week before shooting it. So this might look familiar if you watched my last video. This is a DB15, it's their black gold edition. A lot of it has to do with the lower. I did interchange a lot of parts in this, which I described in my last video. I was able to run 80 rounds through this. Couple of takeaways. So the 5.56 is a very violent round, meaning it's very high pressured, and shooting out of this 7-inch barrel, even suppressed, there was a lot of action going on here. So I'm happy to say that this thing functioned flawless. I'm gonna post a video. I'll probably do it at the beginning of this video when I actually upload this. I have a couple different angles of it shooting, but looks like my brass was shooting out about the 2 o'clock position. My only gripe about this setup was the hollow sun, the 403 micro red dot. I don't know why it's called a micro red dot, because it's actually a gold dot. After probably the first mag, this whole upper was red hot. This Reptilia court mount, you couldn't even touch it with your finger. It was so hot. I was having problems with this gold dot by Hollow Sun. It kept flickering. The gold dot would disappear. I'd have to tap it or adjust the dial. So little background on the original gold dot I had on there. I got it from Optics Planet. It was one of their open box sales that they had, meaning it was like on display. And I think I mentioned in my last video how easy this was to turn. So I just got this yesterday in the mail. The turnaround time was 5 days. Optics Planet made it right without hesitation. They sent me a shipping label and said, hey, as soon as you get this sent out, call us back and we'll confirm that the package was shipped back out, and we'll get you your new one back to you. So I did. I got it yesterday. This is a night and day difference from that open box model. It looks completely different. It feels completely different. So I don't know how long that one that I purchased was out for display. So this dial is just like my Aimpoint T2 Micro. It is extremely stiff to turn this. The first one I had, it was super easy, and I remember I was like, wow, I really like that. So anyway, I didn't like how hot this got. It made sense. I knew it was gonna do that. I didn't feel like it was gonna do it that quick though. Unfortunately, there was other folks shooting next to me. The sound reduction wasn't what I thought it was going to be. Still had a pretty good flame thrown up the front of this muzzle. Rugged does make a removable tip, to cap screw, I should say, specifically for like a birdcage hider. So you see I'm unscrewing this cap on here. And I want to say it's like $100. I don't know if it's going to be worth it. I'm really not concerned about it. I'm a nobody. I'm not trying to mitigate or hide my location if I ever had to shoot at somebody or whatever, and giving away my position. So that really doesn't have anything to do for me. I don't do night hunting, if that plays a factor. But other than that, the thing was super accurate, super reliable. Like I said, the only downfall was the optic kept cutting out on me. I even changed the battery and it still kept doing it. So this, not only did everything up here get extremely hot, so did the optic. The optic got like, if I were to say anything, I would say it was very close to melting hot. I have the Magpul rail ladder on here. I don't know if it was the BCM scales or the Magpul ladder. I could smell something cooking though. It smelled like a plastic. It wasn't like a metal or a paint. And this trigger, crazy how after only 80 rounds got extremely smooth. And I dry fire this all the time, but actual shooting, you know what? I didn't do a safety check just in case I was going to shoot Winnie all through the screen. But this was like an $86 trigger. It's a JM Tactical, the James Madison Tactical, like Black Ops, Evo, something of that nature. But very pleased with everything else. I'll go back this week and probably run another 2 makes through it. And make sure at least the optic runs fine. Out of all the holosuns that I own, this is the first holosun that I've had a problem with. So, anyway, I doubt Optics Planet's ever going to see this, but shout out to them. They definitely made it right. They got me my replacement optic super fast. Like I said, it was a 5-day turnaround. Would have been sooner, but Thanksgiving was 2 days ago. So, anyway, guys, if you have any questions, let me know. I just wanted to do a quick follow-up, and I'll throw in some shooting footage of this guy. Have a good day.